أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا زدنا علما وارزقنا فهما وجعلنا من أصحاب القرآن وجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I know it's me, Sister Sabiha will not join us today. She has thing to do. She say, okay. May Allah make everything easier for you. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Now we are talking about these few words from Sister Lisa. Alma, Sister Salma will explain about this, I think. Okay, so we can wait for her for this word, and then Qad and Faqad. Based on the translation that Sister Lisa also sent to us, let's see. Okay. Give me a moment. Faiza, Faiza. At once. At once. And then. So. I don't know, for me this word like kama, ka'annama, faqad, they are combination of two harfs, of two huruf. Fa'idha is combination of fa and idha, but I'm not sure, I cannot give you like, you know, the reason why or the proof, something, I cannot give that to you. So maybe if other sisters join here, we can discuss about this. For now, as it only me, no one show up yet, I'm going to do the revision of jumlah. I want to do that. So let's see. By the way, I lost three notes of this revision session, so I have to make it again by myself. Now I feel that I saved the recording. That's benefit for me. I can see again what we already put in our notes. Anyway, we start, of course, from the very basic. There are two kinds. Oops, sorry. Two kinds of sentences. Jumlah ismiyah. And jumlah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We are going. Okay, I think is the best sentence. This is the best sentence. Okay. Composition like this. Mubtada, khabar, muta'alliq, will, khabar. So at least need mubtada and one of the other two. Meaning you can have mubtada and khabar, or you can have mubtada and muta'alliq bil khabar, but the mubtada is a must. Need to. At least need to. Composition and mubtada is a must. Okay. Now jumlah fi'liyah, composition. We have fi'il. Fa'il, maf'ul, muta'alliq bil fi'il. At least need to composition. Fi'il and fa'il. Need to must composition. So yeah, let's see. Yeah, I think this is good. Two kind of sentences. Jumlah ismiyah, ism based sentence. It the composition, we have three compositions. Mubtada, khabar, muta'alliq bil khabar. At least need two compositions. Mubtada is the must. Then the second one is jumlah fi'liyah. It is a fi'il based sentence. Composition, fa'il, fa'il, fi'il, fa'il, maf'ul, muta'alliq bil fi'il. At least need to must composition, fa'il and fa'il. So fi'il and fa'il is a must. And then those two composition are enough to make a jumlah fi'liyah. Alright. Now, example. Huwa talibun fi ma'hadi bayyina. Oh, I should make it in the column, yeah. Okay, I can make it 1 to 3. Let's try again. I don't think so. I don't think yes. I think yes. Huwa talibun fi ma'hadi bayyina. This is muta'alliq bil khabar. This is khabar and this is mubtada. You can also only say huwa talibun. That's enough to make it jumla ismiyah. Yeah. Oh no. Okay. I don't think anyone will join me in this session. But it's okay. This is only the basic one. Everyone know this. No. Let me add again. 1, 2, 3. Okay. But this is enough for to make the ismiyah. Okay. Okay, but they are in the group. Let's see why. Oh, someone here. Assalamualaikum, sister.
Waalaikumsalam.
Okay. Yeah, we are talking about the jumlah now. Start from the very basic one. Eh? Okay. And then. Example for this. We need 4. Yeah. Nasara Ahmadu Ahmadu Mariamun. Ah. Rio Masjid. So, this is the Isra'il. Isra'il. Maf'ul. And muta'alliq bil fi'il. Yeah. These are jumlah ismiyah. Ah, sorry, jumlah fi'liyah. But you can only say Nasara Ahmadu. That's enough to make a jumlah fi'liyah. Even you can also say only Nasara, because inside the fi'il it's already fa'il there. Fi'il wafa'iluhu. Yeah. So we can do that. Okay. Now, oh, you need more space here. Still not now. Okay, now add here. We have jumlah fi'liyah. Okay. That's all the basic jumlah in Arabic, basic sentences in Arabic. I think that's enough. Now we can move to the jumlah ismiyah. Basic jumlah. Okay. Well, only two of us sister.
Basically, maybe they haven't realized the schedule is changing.
Yeah. What should we do here in jumlah ismiyah? Normal order. Mubtada, and then khabar. And then muta'alliq bil khabar. Okay. unusual order will create special meaning such as
Jesus.
Yeah. Jesus. Is timar apa lagi itu what pas etc. Okay, and then what you can make is a special order. Possession sentence. Now, so we should talk about the composition first. Is mubtada ya? Ada topik. Main part of jumlah ismiyah. Supposed to be rafa wa ma'rifa. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. Supposed to be rafa wa ma'rifa. What else about the mubtada? Supposed to come first, something like that, yeah. Okay, what else about mubtada? Good.
That's it.
Yeah. That's it. Yeah, and then khabar ya. Information. Supposed to be rafa wa nakirah. After the mubtada. Give. Yeah, I think that's this. Give information of the mubtada supposed to be rafa and nakira supposed to come after the mubtada, and then
that's it.
All right. Thank you. I accidentally delete 3 notes of our revision session. I have to write all of them again.
Permanently delete?
Sorry?
Permanently deleted?
Yes.
Oh no.
Yeah, I know.
Muscle.
Yeah. Fire. Okay, thank you. The last part is the Mota Alik Bill. Bilam. Bila kabar, okay. Extra information.
Yes.
Okay. Usually in jar wa majrur or idafa form. Yeah.
Yes.
Supposed to come last. What else? Must be there to create jumlah ismiyah. Or in harf nasab wa ismu ha form. Does that make sense?
Yes.
What else? I don't think. Supposed to come last. Yeah, I think that's all in Mutalik bin Khabar.
Yes.
All right. Then normal order. Unusual order will create special meaning such as efficient. When it comes with kana family. Oh no, it's a bit khobar,
yeah? Yeah.
In the when it comes with kana should be in a substatus. Oh no, this one no. Can be Lin. Ask me fragment as long as it is. And then here, when it comes with half nasal, when it comes in, the status should be nasal. Or will be nasal. It will be in, yeah. Nasal status. Let's see that. Meaning can be in any fragment as long as it is rofa. You can have mubtada in mausul sifa or idafa, right?
Say again, sorry.
Yeah, meaning you can have mubtada in mausul sifa or idafa fragment.
Yes, yes, you can.
Mm-hmm. As long as it is rofa, yeah.
Yes.
Only when it comes in half nasab, wa ismu hafal, it will be nasab. And then that makes sense too, yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, everyone join. Assalamualaikum, Sister Salma, Sister Sarwat.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah. So yeah, that's all we see. Jumlah ismiyah, composition, mubtada, khabar, muta'alliq bil khabar. Anything else you wanna add here in the composition section?
So it's all about composition.
Yeah, for now.
Okay, like we when something is muqaddam or muakhar, it will be discussed later.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's all in composition.
Yeah.
I think so. Yes. This is the basic things, yeah. So normal order, mubtada, khabar, muta'alliq bil khabar. Unusual order will create special meaning such as ikhtisas, ikhtimar, and many more. Special order. Okay, what I mean by special order is, you know, kind of possession sentence. When jar wa majrur, la jarwa majrur lahu and then followed by mubtada nakira.
That will special template.
Yeah.
We usually call it special template.
Oh, special template. Okay.
What is ikhtimar? Have you studied?
Yeah. Ustad mentioned a few times. Yeah. I think this is emphasis. Ikhtimar. This is often, Ustad often use this term. Okay, I will search more, inshallah. Before we go to special template, Sister Salma, you were talking about Amma yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah, can you continue, please?
Oh, I just know this. This is kind of shocking type of things. Yeah.
So if this the meaning, so I think amma is kind of ism, no?
Yeah, I don't know actually.
The comparison is khabar, yeah?
Is it amma becomes amma?
Yeah, I was thinking the same, but in surat what? Amma yatasa'al. So let's see. So this is the comparison.
Is it the same amma which is in Surah Naba?
We have another amma.
Maybe I have written like there was no alif. Maybe so I thought no, because I have seen it like ayn and meem, and no, there is no alif.
In where?
In Surah Naba, which you just mentioned.
Oh, we don't have alif.
Oh. I think so.
Yeah, let's.
Yes, no alif. It's amma.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I can hear then myself. Oh, okay. So this is not the one.
Yeah, this is the different one. Yeah.
Yeah. And then Sister Sarwat, maybe right. Amma is from An Enma, something like this, yeah.
Maybe.
Let's check if we have Amma. I don't know, Sister Lisa. Maybe Sister Lisa knows this.
Yes.
Oh, amma of what? So this is in Surat Baqarah ayat 85. Wa mallahu bighafilin amma ta'maluna. Amma anma. So yeah. This is
and two. It means what? Yeah, it means what kind of things? What?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Because this is half jar, this is should be mausulah. Yeah. In here, yeah, in this ayah. Okay. So that's solved. Ka'an nama. I think also this is
hard. Two words. Yeah. Have we discussed Aina and Ai? Remember?
Yeah.
I was thinking that because so many things. So
yeah.
I thought to tell you, but no, then I forgot.
Yeah. I think you told me, yeah, but I forgot to.
No. I read somewhere and I thought we studied this like in revision. So
okay. So let put here question. Is the farm,
yeah.
Is the farm. Okay, that's cool. We can talk about Isam Istifham and the rest of this tonight, 8 p.m. Jakarta 8 p.m. time. Yeah, 8 p.m. the time.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like how many hours from now? 12?